Hey guys, this is Vaish from Vaish IAS. So MCQ 1 to 5 of the older current affairs, that's 2016 to 18 current affairs, which is very much important for this prelims. I showed you 1 to 5 questions and answers. So now we'll see the question number 6 to 10. Okay. So this is Sugamya Pustakalai, an online library for persons with print disabilities, is launched by whom? Okay, just the ministry name. Okay, but in the explanation we will get a lot more details. So we'll see after that. Now we'll see the next question. Masala bonds. Okay, so it's explaining you the concept. Okay, three statements are there. It's a rupee denominated bonds sold by Indian entities in the overseas market. That's first statement. Second statement, they were named so by the International Finance Corporation, an arm of the World Bank. So here, if that statement is true, you're getting not only the information that it is launching the masala bonds, also you get like it is an arm of the World Bank. So that is how each question helps you. Okay. Third one, ICICI Bank was the first to issue masala bonds since RBI cleared it in September 2015. So if that was true, that is true means this is the reason maybe the question is framed. Okay, if it is true. Okay. So this is how questions will be framed. Now, next one. Tarang, E-Trans and Deep, recently in the news, are apps of which ministry? Okay, so seeing the name, you can like confuse like whether it is like something related to road or maybe power or coal or is aviation, railway. It looks similar to everything. Okay, so by names, you cannot guess it because UPSC, I mean, at least this government, they are going on launching that many apps and digitizing everything. So that many terms are there in news. So it's very difficult to relate with the name alone. Okay, you have to know the concept. Now, next one. The Habitat Commitment Index, okay, it's UPSC's favorite actually, rates the habitat progress of nations based on which all factors, okay, maybe like I think 2016 they asked the Global Hunger Index, what are the factors, okay, like it's malnutrition or stunting or something and all. So same way here, poverty, infrastructure, employment, sustainability, gender, institutional capacity, six things are given, okay, and whether all these factors are there in the index preparation, okay, Habitat Commitment Index. Now, next one. Which of the following are true regarding funding of NGOs? Okay, this is very much in the news because NGOs are getting shut down, many things are getting monitored, okay, foreign funding is blocked. So a lot of things are there. So statements are, most NGOs are receiving funds as per FCRA, okay, which is monitored by Home Ministry. Okay, so the body and the ministry you have to confirm there. Second one, there are also few NGOs which receive funds from international donors registered under FEMA. Okay, so FCRA also is there, FEMA also is there, okay, funding. Now FEMA comes under the purview of Commerce Ministry. So again, it's a ministry and body of the foreign funding. That's the only thing in this question we are checking. Okay. So we'll see answers now. 6 to 10 in the answer PDF. Okay. We saw El Nino in the last video. Then locations, one environment related, and two other questions. Okay. Sixth question. Okay. Here, Sugamya Pustakalai. So it is under Ministry of Social Justice. Okay. Here in the option itself, first option we put Human Resource Development because students have a tendency to think like because it's Pustakalai, maybe it is like a library kind of thing and it is related to human resource. But it is an online library only, but it's for print disabled. Okay. It's like the disabled people. Okay. The visually disabled people. So for that, it is actually taken care by the Ministry of Social Justice. Okay. So here, the details you can pause and read. Okay. I'll keep it here. So here, it's actually again the same thing. Okay. You have understood the concept. It's just for the Divyang people who cannot see, for them the Braille scripted books, okay, that books is in a library, that is Sugamya Pustakalai. So that one will be there in the ministry of this thing, okay, under the ministry of this thing, under department of empowerment of people. Okay, so again little bit details are here, we're connecting it to the international forums and all related to the same thing. Okay, so that is the first question. Second question today is masala bonds, which is important. Like masala bonds are there, green bonds are there, blue bonds are there. For everything, we have an MCQ. Okay, now 6500 MCQ, every concept one MCQ is there, and that will explain you what the topic is. That is our guarantee. Okay, so here again, if you see 1 and 2 is the answer, that means third statement is wrong. Why the third statement is wrong? Because it's not ICICI Bank, it's HDFC Bank, and that was the news. This question was found because of the news. If you see the blue color hyperlink at the bottom, the news link. The link itself tells you HDFC raises rupees 500 crore. So this news came and that is why this question is framed. So we will check only whether you read the news. So if you know that alone, the 3 and 3 you can eliminate in B and, C and D. Okay. Then 1 and 2 you have to know. So 1 and 2, it's like this IFC. Okay. IFC launched the first one. That was another news which happened 1 year before that. Okay. So that is how you are checking. We are checking only the current affair. If you know the current affair, static gets solved automatically. Okay. That is how UPSC also puts the question. They are just checking you whether you learnt that one thing which we are expecting you to learn. Okay. So here if you see the first statement, entities in the overseas market, okay, rupee denominated. So that is exactly correct only. Okay, well, that is the definition of masala bond. Okay, and the principal interest, everything will be in this thing only, in the rupee denomination. Okay, and the first one, it was by IFC, the World Bank arm, which launched it. And now in after RBI cleared it, ICICI Bank has launched it. HDFC Bank has launched it. Okay, so that is how 1 and 2 is correct and 3 is wrong because it is not ICICI. Now this one, okay, which apps it is related to. So it is actually Ministry of Power and Power and Code. Okay, everything is actually for the transparency. Okay, these three things: Tarang, E-Trans, and Deep. The full forms, if you see, pause and see what is Tarang standing for, what is E-Trans, and what is Deep. It's actually about the bidding or whatever happened, the auction. Okay, of these coal mines and all these things. So these things to make it transparent and to make no illegal thing happening behind it, so that everyone knows what is happening and to expedite the process also. Okay. That is how ease of doing business, everything will get improved, because now it's happening very transparently, people will come to know. So all three are actually same, but very slightly, slightly. One is for auction, one is for reverse auction, one is for interacting with the consumers or whatever. So if you pause and see, you will understand what these three things are. But basically it is for that transparency in the auctions or bidding process. Okay, that is the gist of it, and that much only you need to know. You no need to know very detail about each app, because you are not going to use this app also, and it is not a part of UPSC standard also. They will not ask into detail of each app. Okay. So it was in PIB. Now this one, Habitat Commitment Index, UPSC's favorite. So here everything is true. Okay, this question was framed so that you come to know about this. Also, it's not, you suppose an index has some 12, 13 factors, then you don't, we are not expecting you to do. Okay, UPSC is not also expecting from you to by heart all those 13 factors of an index. But if it is like up to maybe 5 or 6 or 8 factors, okay, then it becomes important. Like there is that multi-dimensional poverty index, okay, of the UNDP. There, I think there is three main factors, and under that there are 10 factors. So that is important, because up to 10 factors and all UPSC can ask. Okay, it's like a, it's like in under student capacity, student can by heart it. Okay, 10 factors are possible, humanly possible. So that UPSC, here also 6 factors it has. Okay, so that is why we put this question. 6 factors is thing which UPSC is expecting you to by heart. Okay, so this Habitat Commitment Index, red highlighted, okay, it is there towards the bottom. Infrastructure, poverty, employment, sustainability, institutional capacity, and gender. Whatever mnemonic you want to make, you make it, okay. P-I-E-S-I or something, whatever, if you make a word out of the first six letters, try to by heart it, okay. And it is like, if here in the same explanation, we are explaining you other things also. There's something called Habitat 1, Habitat 2, Habitat 3, like that conferences happen under the United Nations, okay. The Habitat 3 happened recently, that is how it came in news, okay. And UPSC have asked also, UPSC asked the question about Habitat and the housing summit which happened. Asia Housing Summit. Okay, it came in 2016-17 prelims. That is why it is very, very important. So it happened, if you see, in Istanbul, it happened in 1996. And then after that, again, it happened in 2016 or something. Okay, the Habitat 3. So the location, this thing, it's like that one line, whether it happened or something. Because UPSC asked something like some Africa-India summit happened. And the first summit happened under Jawaharlal Nehru 50 years back. That is one statement which UPSC put. Okay, that means because it happened, the first summit actually happened in 2015 or something. UPSC is asking that minimum thing, whether you have that knowledge that it is something which happened recently and it's not something which Jawaharlal Nehru started. Okay, you don't need to know whether it is 1950, 1960, 1970. You have to know whether it's a new thing or an old thing. Same way here also. Okay, Habitat 1, 2, 3, whether it is happening from when. Okay. Or actually three summits happened. That minimum thing you should know. Okay, pause it and read this thing. NGOs, so funding, okay. Here the third statement is wrong. Why? Because the FEMA, okay, Foreign Exchange Management Act, it is under the Ministry of Finance, not under the Ministry of Commerce. The other things are true, okay. NGOs can be funded under FCRA also, under FEMA also, it used to be funded, okay. So, first thing, FCRA under Home Ministry, FEMA under Finance Ministry, and NGO funding possible under, have been, had used to happen under both, okay. Now things are changing. So, here if you see, the basic details are there, okay, how NGOs are funded and all. After there are some more details like what are the eligibility criteria and things, which is important for mains actually, okay. Foreign funding related question can come in GS3 paper, so that time you need this information. That is why we are given half a page of how actually it is verified or what the NGO funding process is, okay. And it's for general psychologists, NGO funding is very much into interest for UPSC students. That is why we thought about NGO details we gave. So one page explanation is there for this thing. Okay. That's for mains, totally for mains. Now it's prelims time. I'm not going to detail. So here it's just the ministry and the body you need to know. And it's not Commerce Ministry, it's Finance Ministry. Okay. The FEMA. So this is how questions are framed. So 10 questions I showed you. And this is how fast you can learn. Okay. Now I showed you 10 questions in how much it's like 10 minutes of previous video, 10 minutes of this video, 20 minutes you have seen 20 questions. So like this, if you take Vaishya's test papers of 65 tests and start doing, in 30 days, you are going to get the knowledge base which is unparalleled, which is, you cannot have any of your competitor having this much knowledge, okay, that is, we are promising you, okay. So when you think like Vaishya's test, you have not bought, why you should buy, that is the answer. If you have already bought and getting confused between other magazines which you trust more, this is again the same, the answer to that is same, okay. That is why I am showing you these samples. The first quickness in which if you take focus and do this, okay, you are going to gain knowledge faster than others, and you will have time for revision also, and the UPSC paper questions similar to this will come also, okay. So your chances for increase your increasing your mark. Okay, clearing or not, that is up to UPSC's thing. Okay, UPSC, it's like unpredictable. We cannot know what they'll ask. Okay, but your chances comparing to others, your competitors, will be much much higher if you do HIAS test in this format. Okay, take papers and just solve. Okay, so that's it. Now again, in comment section, you tell me like whether any other sample paper you need to see. Okay, there is environment, there is geography, there is economics. Everything I can show you 5 to 10 questions to maybe you understand like what is actually covered in here. Okay, so you can tell me in comment section. I'll make videos for that. So till then, thank you. Enjoy your learning. Have a nice day.